The average price of a CryptoPunk today is about $49,000 worth of Ethereum. And the crazy part, when CryptoPunks were created in 2017, they were given out for free. And following the success of CryptoPunks, other NFT projects followed and they were met with similar success. A good example is Bored Ape Yacht Club. When they released their NFTs, it only cost 0.08 Ethereum to mint them. And today, the floor price for a Bored Ape Yacht Club NFT is 5.8 Ethereum. This is a little over $13,000. And the key to this space is to find these projects early. But the problem is, it is very difficult because it requires many, many hours of research, maybe even days, maybe even weeks to find these projects. But in this video, I'm going to show you a tool that reverse engineers the whole entire process and makes it much easier and faster. And if that sounds good to you, make sure to hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel and hit the bell notification so that when I make these videos, you will find out about them right away. Because on this channel, we like to make things simple and easy. And if that's what you're a fan of, that's exactly what you'll get by subscribing to this channel. And with that being said, let's get into the content. Welcome aboard the Bitcoin Express. My name is Chase. Let's get to it. To understand the NFT landscape, we need to first understand what CryptoPunks is and why it's so special. In 2017, starting out as an experiment, 10,000 unique CryptoPunks were given out for free. And the key here is that they are similar, but they are still unique. You have these faces, they have different hats, different characteristics, different color of hair, and so on. And the key here is to create a community. And this is different than NFT art. When it comes to NFT art, an artist might make 1, 5, or 10 pieces. But with these, let's say, CryptoPunks or Bored Ape Yacht Club, these are communities. And community is something, as humans, that we crave. We have always craved it and it will never go away. If we look at today, what are some of these social badges or these social status symbols that bring us into a community? Some examples for that we see on media is maybe something like a verified checkmark. When someone wears a sports jersey to represent their country or their team, that is a community. When someone, let's say, wears fashion designer clothes, sneakers, again, they are part of a community. And right now we can even see on Jay-Z's Twitter, he bought a CryptoPunk and he made it his profile picture. He is joining a community. This is never going away. We've always craved this. The best example is religion, right? That's the best example of community. And as we move towards a digital world, a metaverse, we will have these digital communities as well. This space is only getting started and it will continue to grow. I believe it's going to be massive. Now, when it comes to these communities and these specific individual NFTs, like we said, you want to get in early. A big mistake that many people make is they buy these NFTs in the aftermarket. This is extremely risky. And when you see NFTs, you might think that it is a friendly space. You see these avatars, these NFTs, you know, they're cute, they're nice, they're colorful. But the truth is, NFT investing and trading is more risky than crypto. When you buy an NFT in the aftermarket, you might pay an extremely high price with no guarantee that you will ever be able to sell that NFT. And the reason is, because NFTs are a highly illiquid market. For example, when it comes to crypto, it's very liquid, meaning that if you buy crypto, you can sell it at any time. This is not the case for NFTs. If you buy $500 worth of crypto, as the price starts to decrease, maybe now it's worth 480, then 470, then 440, and 430, at each and every point, you can sell and get out. You cannot do this with NFTs at all times. You might buy an NFT for $1,000 and the next day maybe you want to sell it for $900 or $800 and there will be no buyer. It's in a liquid market. And actually this year we had a silent crash with NFTs. I did make a video about it. It's only about 6 minutes long. I will leave a link for it down below in the description. It will give you a good idea of what I mean by the NFT market is highly illiquid, making it more risky. So just understand that, because I know a lot of these videos on YouTube are, you know, NFTs are fun, cute, friendly, make money, but they definitely are more risky than crypto. So we just mentioned that you don't want to buy in the aftermarket because you might just pay an extremely high price or something that you might just be stuck with and you might never be able to sell. So what you want to do is get in early. Again, that takes time, hours, days, weeks of research. But I found a tool that reverse engineers the whole entire process and makes it faster and easier, and it's called Rarity Tools. I will, of course, leave a link for it in the description below. And when you go to this website, you want to click on upcoming projects. So instead of doing all the research to find the projects are given to you right away, right? Reverse engineer. And not only that, this website will give you all of the other information that you probably were going to search for. It will give you the Discord group. It will give you the Twitter group. It will give you the website. It will give you the launch date, when it's actually going to be released and how many will be released, along with the price. All the information you need in one spot. But it doesn't stop here. You still have to do further research. Again, we're taking this process from multiple hours or days and just to a matter of, you know, maybe 30 minutes or maybe an hour. So we have all the information we have for these projects, when they are going to first launch, and we're going to get them at the cheapest available price. Now, once you find these projects, you still need to do further research. Remember, we're trying to figure out, is there a community here? This is not like crypto where we say, what industry is it going to take over? Supply chain, is it going to replace gold? Over here, it's really, are people excited about it? Are people talking about it? So let's say we're looking at Crazy Lizard Army and we click on their Twitter page. It will bring us here and we can see they have 2,800 followers. That's actually pretty good. And as we scroll down, we can see that other projects maybe people are not as excited about. Let's say Mixed Fam over here. If we go to their page, 334 followers, nothing really special. Let's scroll down over here and see these other projects upcoming. Jorge Wee, let's click over here. And this has 302 followers, right? No one's really excited about these projects. So probably something that I don't want to pay attention to. And by the way, as you scroll down, you'll start to notice that a lot of these projects are taking that standard from CryptoPunks, right? Not maybe 10,000, but near it. 6,000 total NFTs for this project, Crypto ZBits. This one has, you know, 7,000. This one has 7,500. And they're all similar, but have unique characteristics because we are creating here communities. And as I scroll down here, let's look for a better example. Here, Cosmic Kids. It has the date, this Friday, it's going to be released, 10,000.02 Ethereum. And if we click on their Twitter, we can see that they have almost 4,000 followers. And also, if we go to their website, we'll notice that not only are they just an NFT avatar, but they're also going to create a metaverse and have games. And this is something that you'll start to notice with these projects. CryptoPunks was the original. I believe CryptoPunks will be here for a very long time. But all the new projects have to add something unique. They need to have a benefit. They need to maybe offer games or utility. And that's what we'll start to see with these NFT avatar projects. They won't just be nice pieces to look at. They will have small, maybe even big use cases for them. And this is an example of a project I'm paying attention to, Dogs Unchained. Early August mint date, 9,999 total, still waiting on a price. But if I click on their Twitter, I can see they have a large following, almost 4,000 followers, and they are followed by people that I follow. People are talking about them. If we check out their Discord group, they have 1,800 members. That's pretty good. You want to also watch to see if these grow before the launch date. That's a good sign. If I see that before the minting date, that the Discord grows, the Twitter grows, then I know that this has potential. Also, if you go to their website, you'll notice that they're offering benefits and they're going to have a metaverse because they're adding utility. This is probably what's going to have to happen now. In these NFT worlds, you can't just release an avatar. It has to have some benefit, whether it's a benefit for a game, a metaverse, or a community benefit. So I want to give you an example of how this goes. And something I do want to mention, by the way, like I said before, this is not a no-risk zone. When you buy these NFTs, even at mint date, it will cost you somewhere usually between, let's say, $50 worth to $200 worth of Ethereum. And every time that I purchase one of these NFTs, I have to assume that I might not get that money back. Like we said, this isn't like crypto. You can't buy it and then just automatically sell it. You can buy an NFT and then list it for sale, and it might just sit there for days, weeks, or months until it finds a buyer. So with all these projects, you'll notice the price is between, you know, 0.02 ETH to maybe 0.1 ETH, depending on the ETH rate, you know, right now at the moment, anywhere from like $50 to $200 worth of Ethereum. And that's the risk that I'm willing to take. Like I said, yes, these are cute, friendly NFT projects, but NFT investing and trading is more risky than crypto trading. I know it might not seem that way from the videos you see on YouTube of people saying, you know, buy this NFT, it's gonna make you rich. It can happen, but just understand there is a risk to it. So a couple days ago, I was on this site, Rarity Tools, and I saw a project, World of Women NFT. I didn't really pay any attention to it, but I follow Gary V on Twitter, and this is someone you should follow. If you wanna find NFTs, make sure to follow Gary V. And he posted this tweet that he bought a few of these World of Women NFTs. So I started to look into it. I saw there was a community. I saw people were speaking about it. So I decided to go ahead and I bought one. This is the one that I bought. It was 0.07 Ethereum. So that's about $150, $160. And that's money that I may never see again, right? Right now I can go into the marketplace and I could probably sell it for a little under what I paid, or I could hold on to it, see if it appreciates in value. But it's in a liquid market. I may be stuck with this NFT. So it's, you know, a risk that I'm willing to take. I think this is probably the biggest key to this video, is to understand that the NFT space does take money to get into and it does have risk involved. So let's say you are willing to take this risk and spend $50, $100, $200 on an NFT. Well, how does it work? So when you finally find that project, you know the exact price and you know the date it's going to launch, you'll go to the website and you can mint the token. Let me show you an example with this project over here, Scoop Dog Squad. So you go to the website, it will bring you there. And then what you're going to do is connect your wallet. I'm using a MetaMask wallet. And then all these websites, they're gonna look different, but they're all similar. You connect your wallet, and then if it's still available, if they have not all been minted yet, you mint the NFT. So right now I'm minting it. It's sending to my MetaMask wallet, asking for permission. And then it will show us the gas fee, the total price, and then we can confirm. But of course, I'm going to reject this because I do not want this NFT. So you might be confused now and saying, okay, I understand everything you said in this video, how to find the NFTs, but how do I actually use MetaMask? Well, luckily I have two videos for you in the description. The first one is how to set up a MetaMask wallet safely and fund it. And the second video I have down below is once you have a MetaMask wallet set up, how to interact with the NFT space. Because all of these websites for these NFT projects, they will look a little different. But if you watch the video I made below the tutorial, you will get a good general idea of how to interact with the NFT ecosystem, not only to buy NFTs, but also participate inside of the systems. And if you found value in this video, please consider hitting the like button, subscribe to the channel. Thank you for listening, and I'll see you next time.